still use my belt kit and the back frame.
Transfers book, hatchet.
Hatchet.
The vintage one. From a friend, self-made folding saw. The sharpening tools I use outdoors, a Smith diamond rod. Could also use for serrations and saws, for example. But I use this part and a ceramic rod. And for me the ceramic rod is enough to keep the tools sharp. I just need them for cutting wood. And this is a kind of clove with good weapon oil, if I have to oil the things. Today with me, Nature's Adventure, links below. The only, for me, the only real practical hand chainsaw I had in use. You will see it, I think it's pretty cool.
Hello, you.
Yeah.
Hi, YouTube.
Out again with my good friend, Bush Buddy Susanne Williams. Nice to have you with me. Nice to have you guys with us. Welcome, Sepp Waldhandwerk, to a new video. We were quite busy the last time.
Very.
Thanks to all the participants. I had quite some trainings, two or three a week. Outdoor expedition the last weekend, but I hope to be more regular back with you on YouTube in the next time.
The forest is our home in the end, but we've just been traveling.
We are out, but sadly not always yeah, with, exactly. With camera. Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, perfect.
Yeah. Susanne wears this water shoes?
Vibram, they're multi shoes, five finger.
Okay, yeah. Yeah, yeah. Yeah. And I'm still happy with this sandals. Yeah, I wear them all the time. It's nice. They're immediately barefoot with it. Yeah, shorts.
It's warm. It's warm.
Yeah. I think you are more in the environment as with trekking boots. And we talked about, or make jokes about, the Romans. 2000 years ago, they occupied the whole Alps in sandals. So why we should always use heavy boots?
Exactly.
The only difference is you cannot jump so easily from rock to rock, but maybe that's not the sense from hiking, maybe. And I have to take much more care up in the mountains with sandals. Yeah, but why not? This is, was was this, Achtsamkeit?
Yeah, mindfulness, awareness. I was in the Rofan a couple of weeks ago and yeah. I met a mountain guide there. Mm-hmm. And he noticed that I was wearing very light shoes.
Yeah.
And he said, this is exactly it. He said, people are using trekking poles and yeah. big boots.
Yeah.
But it destroys, in German there's a term called Trittsicherheit. It means yeah. sureness on the feet.
Yeah.
And being able to put your feet where you want and be safe. He said, big boots and trekking poles are ruining people's balance and
the knees.
Trittsicherheit. Yeah. Because you just this, instead of using your feet.
Yeah, the only thing, if you have sandals and shorts in summer times, you know, Susanne, you probably get more dicks than you would like to have.
Black cumin oil, buddy. Black cumin oil. It keeps the ticks away.
But you have.
I can at least see them.
To search for them before I go to the shower. What I like to make today is a big Waldhandwerk bushcraft cup. This tree would be awesome, but yeah, just to show it, I do not like to cut any living tree. Hmm.
Maybe we use this one. It's at least bigger than the normal cups we make. The idea would be a bushcraft bucket. Let's use this and for sure you see what I mean, and you can use maybe bigger, thicker trees. Use a part with not many knots in it, otherwise it's heavy to split. A young beech tree, so very good firewood, short fibrous, very stable, and like to make a big cup and a torch out of the same piece. And if someone of you needs boots with steel caps in it and gloves for bushcraft, please use them. I'll learn how to do it right. Strong piece.
Yeah.
Please take care.
I'm watching.
Because she had not finished the coffee already. No, just kidding. If you split wood, always try to hit the center of the wood so it splits the best. And the hard ground below would be better, but I find no tree stump. And I do not like to use a rock, a stone. Make at least 6 parts. My friend Felix Immler from Taschenmesserbuch found the term Waldhandwerktasse. I call it Bushcraft Cup, but he had seen it the first time in my videos. That's why it's good if many people make the same stuff. So more people can learn. I saw this technique on the channel from Fredde from HopXP, links below, like to all shoutouts. And he himself saw it on a US channel back in 2010. But now quite some people know how to make a cool cup in the woods. Now it's easy to make something wrong if you fit the stuff not right together. It's like a puzzle.
Now choose a up and down side. I will use this up, and here I make cuttings on all six pieces, and I split away the inner part of the, so can say, cup. Cut careful, because if you make it too strong, you easily break away this fiber and the cup is not watertight anymore. With fresh wood, these cups are watertight, and later, if they are dry, lay them back in water and they are again watertight. That's funny. Now I let 5-6 millimeters from the outside intact. If you use one piece as measurement, always use the same piece. Because if you use now this piece and then this and then this, you get a step. Was heißt denn Schablone auf Englisch?
Template.
Like a template. Now we split the inner part. On the wood fibers, you see where the split goes. So watch out. Or you can test, split the half of it. It's also easier for the knife. And then you see it went in this direction or in this direction. Let's make this. A point to betoning with a knife, for me it's always the same. All my bushcraft knives, also the simple Morat knives, I use for betoning and I never destroy the knife. But I saw people destroying knives. Also for me, as former carpenter, I think I know a little where I can beton, not if a knot is in here and so on. But also for me, if I would be in an emergency, I never would use my only blade for betoning. Before this I carve 3 hours. It's too dangerous to destroy the knife. Very hard wood. Now you see, you can split here on a thin part, because the wood cuts here. It will not break the outside of your cup. Oh, dangerous. Yeah, but we like 6 of these pieces and we can make this thinner, but with finer carvings, not with betoning. Let's fit the pieces together. Susanne gave me something from her string. It's the thinnest part, but it's enough to bite.
Oh man, that is so smart.
It's nice, girl.
Oh, that's so obvious. Damn, why did I not think of that?
You have not seen my cups. I make them since like years. Yeah,
no?
I make them.
I've never seen you made one. I've seen the finished product, but I've
okay.
never seen you make one.
Okay, yeah.
How cool.
Yeah,
is
I
that?
Make them since my first YouTube videos, you can say, but not bigger ones. And yeah, Felix made a very beautiful one for a as a video for a challenge, you can say. Waldhandwerktasse.
Yeah, and of course it then fits perfectly.
Yeah, and if it's fresh wood,
to start with.
If it's fresh wood, it's watertight.
Hey, I bet you could seal it with resin if it's not fresh wood.
Yeah. People always say this in the comment section,
yeah.
but if it's warm, the resin would dripping and so
sure.
on. So you can make a resin glue, for sure.
But not if you're going to use it for heating.
And at home I use lime, or you bind it with spruce root,
yeah.
or with Susanna's string. This is the best solution. I think I lash it first on the upper side, because on the downside you can press it together. If you press it here together, the downside open. I love meanwhile this simple household cordage, and I see it the first time by Susanne Williams, as we met each other the first time in my trainings area in this mountain animal park. She made a complete bed out of this string, and we guys always need parachute cord with 550 pound. For what? And then I make an upsell video and everyone freaks out. So, use household cordage.
And you can leave it in the forest and it will just go away.
Yeah. This cordage, not the normal cordage. It's no problem, no trash. Maybe too heavy to run around with it, but you collect stuff, you can collect stuff for your camp and so on. I like these cups really very much. And I never needed to seal them, even this one with nearly holes in it. If I go into the water, I'm faster with drinking and pouring, then the water can run out. But if you like, seal it. Please seal it. Here's the cup, and now burn it to the ground. Because my idea is to make a kind of Swedish torch out of it. So we make kindling out of the inner part, and then we set it on fire.
Perfect.
Hey. Susanne's idea right now, I should give a wedge, a small wedge in the downside. So I have a better jet, a better chimney, if I use it as a Swedish torch. Inside here, I thought I cut this and I carve a hole in here for the chimney. But why not? Let's use this. Let's see if it's. Do you see something? No. If it's enough, it's good. Otherwise, I will cut a hole in it.
Yeah, schon bigger da.
Also vielleicht da noch mehr unternehmen.
Yeah. Und der Wirbel wird jetzt auch stabil. Du kannst es in den Boden stecken. Oh, your luck. Okay, I go away.
I use a piece of this stove lighter. I bought a package of them 2 or 3 years ago. I still have them. They last forever. Take care on your fire lighting gear, because this is the most dangerous time to lose items, because you're in a hurry, now you have a flame and whatever. Oh, wrong direction. So something burns. There's fire. There's one flame. But I have no idea what the flame does. The resin starts to melt. And as soon as the resin burns, yeah, we are in the game. I'm not very happy with my torch. It's more a candle, maybe for light in the evening. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So I make something else. My idea was to open the cup again and to make a hole inside for a chimney. But Susanne said, let's put a wedge in it. And you know, for a good relationship, the woman has to have always right. And you have the problems afterwards. So I use my type of wooden nails down here on the back side of each of the parts from the cup. I'm afraid if it burns down and ash and so on fell down, it will go out. But maybe your idea work. Because normal you're always right.
No. I do wish.
Me too, yeah. I made this kind of dent bags in it, because now I can cut this open. And it should not fall apart. And here you have more fuel for your fire. The next time I will cut a Karo. Gibt's das im Englischen? Karo?
A diamond?
A diamond?
Yeah.
Here.
Or a notch.
I will make a notch here and a notch here to have a real chimney.
Like a rocket stove.
Yeah, like what?
You meant. Like what, yes. You intended, yes, before I distracted you.
But okay. Made it for the first time. And think it's a nice bushcraft project. Even in this form you have a nice small torch in your
Garden Backyard Bushcraft Camp. And the last idea, of course, was to heat up water with it. In between, a short shout out to the company Olight. I never thought I would make a flashlight review on my channel, but this is a kind of, what, let's say, product placement. Wow, okay, now we are blind. So, bright, less bright, no, us. Ah, these are the functions. I have no idea, I hate those one button should press everything. Flashlight with three or four functions, one button on top. What I like on it, it's IP8X. You can use it the whole lifetime underwater. It has a magnet to charge it. It's rechargeable. Yeah, it's not heavy. A single tool. They sell it as headlamp, and as headlamp, it was too heavy for me. Otherwise I would have made a review, because I liked for normal a headlamp, but with this clip you can wear it on a jacket and so on, and yeah, it's okay to walk with it. I use it for my corsets, because I also do not like the other headlamp from Black Diamond. What a crap, sorry. No, I'm not sorry. Who invited something like this? If the thing are too cold, you cannot wish the light on. Where do they make this? The functions. Put it off. Put it on. Press on it, it's more bright. Press on it, it's awesome bright. Press on it, it's the normal light. Endless light. Ah, and I think if you press two times, no. There's nothing. If you press one, two, three times. Ah yeah, you have SOS. That's okay. Press three times and leave it, and the mountain rescue team know where to find your body. Okay. Now I mentioned it. Now I can keep it, and now I can annoy me whole day long with it. Links below. Many thanks for watching to you all. Go out in nature, enjoy Mother Nature. Please watch Susanne Williams on her channel, and we see us this time, I hope, sooner in another one. All the best. Sepp, wait on that. Peter, ich geht's aus. Ciao, servus.